In this lesson, we will see how to make our application logic reusable by removing it from the screen logic and placing it inside the reusable action. We will implement a reusable action to update the quantity in stock whenever a product is deleted from an order. So here in the order detail, remember that we have this delete action here to remove a product from an order, and this delete action is implemented in a screen action. And what we want to do is to have a reusable action that actually deletes the order item and updates the quantity in stock for that product. In the OutSystems platform, the logic is implemented using actions. You can execute business logic in the preparation of a screen or in screen actions. And another way to execute logic is using user actions. And you will create these here in the logic tab under this folder, actions. So let's create a user action and let's call it remove order item. A user action allows you to implement business logic that can be reused throughout your application. So you will be able to use this user action in every screen you have in your application, in every screen action of that screen, and so on. Okay, since user actions have their own scope, you need to send data through parameters to be able to access it inside the user action. And in this case, to remove the order item, we will need to receive here as an input parameter the order item that we want to remove. Now, notice that the data type of this element is actually the entity order item. So far, we only have been creating simple data types like booleans, integers, and identifiers, but it is possible to create variables to store a whole record, in this case, an order item. And this order item will have this definition that we have here. So it will have all these attributes that we can use inside this action to compose the logic. So let's do this logic here to remove the order item. What we want to do, the first thing we want to do is to update the quantity in stock for the product. So let me find here the product entity and create an aggregate to fetch the products. And in this case, we want to filter this aggregate with the identifier of the product that we have in the order item. So this attribute here. And we want this identifier to match the product ID. Okay, so we have the product. Let's go back here into the logic. Now that we have fetched the product from the database, we can change the quantity in stock attribute of that product. So we'll use an assign node here to update that value. And we want to say that the quantity in stock is equal to, let's set here the expression, is equal to the quantity in stock that we have there at the time, plus the quantity that we have in the order item that we are going to remove, that we are going to delete. So this quantity here. So we set the quantity in stock. Now we can update the product. Let's go here into the data tab and update the product. This will be the product that we fetch with the aggregate. And now that we have updated the product, we can now safely remove the order item. So here we will use the delete order item. And we need to specify the identifier, and we will get the identifier again from the input parameter. It's the ID attribute of the order item that we receive as parameter. Okay. Our action is pretty much done. Now we want to reuse this user action in our screens. So back here in the order detail, we have the delete link, which goes into binds to this screen action, to the delete screen action. And here we have the delete order item, and I want to replace this. So let me remove. I want to replace this delete order item with the action that I have just created. So use here the remove order item. Now we'll need to specify what order item it is that I want to remove. And this we will get from the table records with the current property, the order item entity that we have there. This is the order item that we want to remove. Okay, it seems that we're done. Let's publish and test our application. Okay, let's select one of the orders that we have in our application. Let's say this one, for instance, number 4. And let's remove this order item. But before I do this, let me just go here and open the products link in a new tab. And let's look into the Logitech. So the quantity in stock is 0 for the Logitech headset. And we're going to remove 3 elements. We're going to remove 3 items of this product from this order. So this means that our quantity in stock will be increased by 3 elements. Let's go ahead and do this. There, the item was removed from the order. Let's go here back into the screen and let's refresh the list. And there you have it. Now we have 3 items of the Logitech headset product. And that's it.